just now, Jane, with a rather extraordinary statement saying that they are planning a gilt market operation, which is an intervention from the Bank of England, they say, to try to restore orderly market conditions. Let me just read out part of this statement, literally just in the last few minutes from the Bank of England. They say, as the governor said in the statement on Monday, the bank is monitoring developments in financial markets very closely in light of the significant repricing of UK and global financial assets. The repricing has become more significant in the past day and is particularly affecting long-dated UK government debt. Now, what they're talking about there is essentially part of the thing we've been talking about recently, the yields on government debt, which have spiked up to the highest rate that we've seen since the financial crisis. The statement goes on, were dysfunction in this market to continue or worsen, there would be a material risk to UK financial stability. This would lead to an unwarranted tightening of financial conditions and a reduction in the flow of credit to the real economy. So essentially saying that this could, well, we're already seeing it, aren't we? You were just talking to Ian about this, the fact that mortgage lenders are pulling some of their products because of what's happening right now. In line with its financial stability operations, so the bank has two roles here. They have a role of dealing with what's going on in the monetary side, that's interest rates, and financial stability as well. So looking, making sure the market can function. The bank stands ready to restore market functioning and reduce any risks from contagion to credit conditions for UK businesses and households. This is the key bit. Sorry, I'm reading this out because we have literally just got it. To achieve this, the bank will carry out temporary purchases of long-dated UK government bonds from the 28th of September. So that's what they are planning to do. Obviously, that's from today. The purpose of these purchases will be to restore orderly market conditions. The purchases will be carried out on whatever scale is necessary to affect this outcome. The operation will be fully indemnified by HM Treasury. So it's been coordinated with the Treasury. I could go on, but that's the main part of this statement. This is not quite similar to quantitative easing. That's one of the things that, you know, many of you might have thought when you heard about the government kind of going in and buying government debt, because it's not to fulfil a monetary objective. It's to try to calm those markets down and get them functioning properly. This is the bank intervening to try to get the markets working again, and intervening on, you know, quite a novel basis. I don't recall seeing anything quite like this during the financial crisis. And it's specifically looking at the government bond market. The idea is that, you know, they can see what's happening right now, as we can. They are worried about it. And where we got their statement on Monday, this is going further than the statement. This is actually intervening, and obviously follows the IMF's announcement yesterday of their concern. So we've just had that.
Ed, just explain. Sorry to cut across you, Ed, but just explain to us what the bank will carry out temporary purchases of long-dated government bonds. In layman's terms, what does that mean?
It means they are going. So long-dated government bonds. That is basically those. It's government debt. It's government debt that the government issues to try to finance itself. And the bank has two roles. It has a role of just making sure that interest rates are kind of working and getting out there into the economy. But it also has another role to make sure that all of the markets, and that includes these government bond markets, includes other markets as well, seem to be functioning properly. And what they do is they monitor that to make sure that there are no disturbances and to make sure that money is able to get out there to people who need it. And that's their verdict on that latter part, the financial stability part, that they need to step in to make sure these markets are functioning. I'm sorry, I'm looking down at my kind of screen because literally this statement has just arrived. And the risk really is that you see what's happening now, and this, I think, is what's in the minds of the policymakers at the bank who have been monitoring this. You see what's going on in the interest rate on those long-dated government debt. And remember, those interest rates have gone up from kind of where they were around kind of 3%, 4%, well, 3% or so, up to 4.5%, I think, this morning on at least the 10-year government debt. Those are movements which, you know, as Ian said before, and I'm sure we'll reiterate, this is almost unprecedented. It's certainly very unusual to see such big movements in these markets. And that in turn affects all of the rest of us, because if you've got that kind of yo-yoing around, it means getting money to people who need it, whether through mortgages or other kinds of lending, becomes very difficult. And you see kind of what you're seeing at the moment, which is mortgage lenders just pulling back, saying, we're not quite sure what to do with our products, how to price them at the moment, because the market looks so unstable. So the fact that the bank has intervened in this way, it's not an interest rate hike. Well, there you can see the news release. It's not an interest rate hike, which is what some people might have been expecting from the bank. It is something else. It's something unusual. It is an intervention which, like I say, I can't remember anything quite like it, because it's not like quantitative easing where they're printing money in order to buy government debt. They are getting money out there, which I assume is not going to be monetarily financed, although I'm going to have to, you know, have a deeper look at this. They are getting money out there to try to target parts of the government bond market that they feel aren't really functioning right now. So an extraordinary intervention from the Bank of England will bring you more on precisely how it works and what the implications could be, as well, of course, as the market reaction. Actually, if you wait there, I will literally just look at my screen while I'm talking to you and just see what's happening to gilt markets. Well, look, I'm just looking at the rate on UK government debt, which is, this is what we're talking about here. I'm looking at the 10-year bond, and the yield on that, as I say, which is what I'm talking about, is down from 4.5% straight away. It dropped down to about 4.2%. Again, a very big move indeed. It's come up to about 4.3, 4.37 at the moment. So we're seeing some big movements here, some big reaction. Everyone out there in the market trying to understand what the bank is doing here. It's clear, though, that they are intervening because they are very concerned, deeply concerned about what's happening in financial markets right now.